Hello, my name is Rob Sadler, and it's my pleasure to introduce you to local charity Golf in Society, who are doing some amazing work in and around Yorkshire, transforming the lives of our aging population. I recently met up with three of their workers and volunteers at the wonderful Hillsborough Golf Club in Worrell, just outside Sheffield, to witness some of their amazing work firsthand. Golf in Society put golf at the heart of local communities by delivering tailored golf sessions for those living with chronic illnesses like dementia, Parkinson's disease, loneliness, depression, and many more issues. They began sessions at Hillsborough Golf Club last year, and they are now holding them locally in Rotherham at the Sheffield Hallam University Sports Park on Bawtry Road in Tinsley. I'm now going to find out how you and your loved ones can take part. First of all, I met the club professional Tom Pipes, who runs the sessions.
We're sat up in one of the club rooms, surrounded by lots of names on the board. I think it's been, did you say it's been going since?
Yeah, since 1920.
Right, 1920.
So we had our centenary in lockdown. Yeah. A few years ago, yeah, so a few celebrations and that.
Fantastic. So could you introduce yourself and what you actually do here?
Yeah, I'm Tom Pipes. I'm the head teaching professional here at Hillsborough Golf Club. I've been sort of working here and playing here for a good few years now, and sort of my role's progressed, and then we've got involved in different things such as Golf in Society.
And how did the link to Golf in Society come about?
Well, Anthony first sort of reached out to us a couple of years ago, and we're always looking for things that we can do to help the local community here in the basically at the club. So we had it where we had people who live 5 minutes down the road and they'd never been up the drive because it was always quite a high sort of, what should we say, a little bit more cliquey. So again, we wanted to try and get more people into the club, more people where we actually do things for the community instead of just seemingly for ourselves.
Fabulous stuff. So we were talking earlier, we've just been sat round downstairs. A lot of the golfers have just come in. Yeah. Be lots of banter, be very, very funny. Absolutely amazing to see people's reactions. What do you see? What's the best things you see about the golfers out there?
I think the big thing for me is you see a progression. Obviously, golf is seen as almost an older person's sport anyway, but we've seen the other side of things come in where we've got a lot more younger people coming in. Mm-hmm. But also then we've got something where if you can't then go out there and walk 4.5 miles, you can't go out there and play for 4 hours at a time, there is somewhere else that you can go, and there is a bit more of a grouped exercise that we can do together where it's actually open to everybody. It's a bit more inclusive. Also, we've got the other side of things where there's no time where you can't start. So again, we've had a recent lady get joined in with us where she's about to turn 90 and she's never touched a golf club before. Exactly. So again, you can teach an old dog new tricks. Mm-hmm. And again, it's just a way of making the sport and the club a lot more inclusive.
So you can sort of tailor it so they don't have to do the full 18 holes. They could do three or four holes.
Yeah, so sometimes it's three or four holes. Sometimes it's half holes. Sometimes it's actually just sticking to the driving range and doing specific skills and breaking it all down on a bit more of a personal level. And again, we have a couple of different groups when it comes down to Golf in Society. Some are older people that have been playing for a long time, but then now they can't physically walk around. For other people, it's actually the other side of things. So they've never played before and they want something else to do and actually keep their brain, their mind, and their basically keep themselves active.
Fabulous. So what's your role in that? Do you sort of encourage them to play and encourage the golfers to play, or do you refine their game?
I'm trying to do everything, and again, trying to get everybody hopefully on the seniors tour maybe at some point.
Right, okay. Excellent.
No, in all seriousness, it's all about just making the game and the place fun and including everybody that we possibly can, because in the past it's always been that once you can't play, then that's it, you can't really, or you don't come to the club.
So when you go out there in a group, what's a normal size of group?
So we've had anything from 2 to about 8. Now, depending on if the weather's very good, if you're on holiday, if you're whatever. I think this morning we've had 5. It's really lovely. We tend to have a couple of volunteers, a couple of coaches. So again, we tend to have either 1-to-1 or 1-to-2 sort of coaching just to make sure everybody's okay and everybody's attended to.
So what happens with the carers? Do they sort of sit away? Do they go and have a break, or do they get involved if they want to?
This is so personal because again, this is the whole point in the project, is that it is for everybody. It's for the person taking part, but it is also for the carers. Some carers really love getting involved and they want to learn the game. Some people want to go out for a walk. Some people want to sit and read the book. Some of them actually sit together and have a chat. Actually, it's as much for them as it is for the participants.
And next, I spoke to Jack Samways from Golf in Society, who organised the original pilot project.
Right then, could you introduce yourself, please, and tell me what role you've got in golfing society?
Okay, so my name's Jack Samways. I am the occupational therapist and sort of lead on the research project, which is connected to golfing society.
So what's the research project about then?
So the research project is to look at the impact of playing golf as a physical activity on people with dementia, memory loss, changes in cognition, Parkinson's, frailty. So we're working with that cohort, that population of people. People don't necessarily have to have a diagnosis, and they come to us and take part in a 12-week program that looks at how that playing that sport impacts their physical and mental well-being.
So what do you measure then specifically?
So the measurements are taken by Sheffield Hallam University.
They're okay.
At, indicators for improvement in physical health. So they might look at sit to stand, walking, grip strength, that sort of thing. But they also have measures for people's well-being, how they are sort of mentally, how they feel that the program is going or benefiting them.
And how's the results been going so far? Have you managed to measure anything?
It's been really positive.
Has it?
We've
excellent.
We've seen some improvements in people's physical strength, people's mobility. We've seen improvements in people's cognition in terms of their ability to concentrate on what they're being required to do or follow prompts or questions. It's been really interesting so far.
So what's been the most impressive part of that? What's really grabbed you?
I think what's really grabbed for me is the transformative impact that playing golf can have.
Mm-hmm.
So I came into this thinking sport that golf was a sport for people who played it previously, but actually it's a sport for everybody.
Yeah.
You know, and I think one of the things that Anthony says, who is sort of the founder of Golf and Society, is that it takes a lot of decisions to actually just play one shot.
Yes.
And it's when you see those decisions together that you really get an idea of how valuable this sport is in terms of people's, you know, physical health and their.
So if someone hasn't played golf before, what's their normally their reaction? Are they sort of a bit confused about how you do it? And I've tried it. I tried playing it. I was dreadful.
But yeah, I wouldn't say I'm particularly hot myself, but
yeah.
I think it's people often come in and people are a little bit cautious. But one of the great things about the program that Golf and Society runs is that it's very accessible.
Yeah.
So we work with people at their level. And I think with the occupational therapy and physiotherapy input, we can also explore any personal barriers people have.
Okay.
And that's what makes this quite different from maybe some of the other stuff that Golf and Society are doing.
Yeah.
It's just having that combination of almost like an MDT approach.
Yeah.
Where you're thinking about a wraparound support. So if people come to us and they've got a little bit of frailty or they're a little bit anxious about mobilising, maybe we'll just work with them in an indoor space, you know, build up that confidence. And then when they feel more able to get outside, we'll transition into that outdoor space.
If they've not had any interest in sort of in doing lots of exercise before, what would you say? What would you say to just to get them prepared for them to get into this?
I mean, the best thing to do is to come down for a taster session.
Mm-hmm.
We'll do 90-minute taster sessions on a Tuesday and a Wednesday. So Tuesday in Sheffield, Wednesday in Rotherham. That gives people an opportunity to come down, see the venue, feel welcome in that space and have a chat. You know, from that point onwards, we can then look at them engaging in a little bit of physical activity. You know, we can meet them at where they are in terms of their levels of ability. And then we can explore how that program might be beneficial to them. They get a chance to try a little bit of golf. We go through a little bit of an assessment to understand their background, any physical health issues, any, you know, anything medications they're on, that sort of thing. And then from there, we can look at how we can include them in the study. So really, I would say that this, you know, Golf and Society and the research project, it is for everybody.
Yeah.
Because it has that support and that's in place. And that's what makes it quite different.
As I mentioned earlier, Golf and Society have a new venue on our patch. This is at Sheffield Hallam University Sports Park on Bawtry Road in Tinsley, and it's very, very easy to get to. It's very near the M1. I'll let Jack tell you more about the sessions.
And when do these sessions begin?
So they're already running.
It runs
as a 12-week, so a 12-week rolling program.
Yeah.
So we've got a couple of people already started in Rotherham.
Mm-hmm.
We've got a cohort in Sheffield that's already been taken, sort of, that's about halfway through. So
okay.
As people get recruited into the project,
and it just keeps rolling on. So someone joins, it's still a 12-week session.
That's right, yeah.
Excellent. Yeah. Oh, that's great.
Following the two discussions, I headed downstairs to the club bar to talk to some of the golfers and to their carers. So first of all, I'm going to begin with Sue, who's looking after Arthur.
Right, I'm just talking now to Sue, who's just been involved in today's session. I just want to get sort of Sue's feedback about what she feels about how it's going. Are you enjoying it?
Yes, it's really good. It's good to have the OT. It's good to have the physio here to be able to help Arthur to get the most out of the sessions.
Yeah.
He had his half-time assessment or midway assessment last week.
Yeah.
And he's stronger and able to walk faster than he did initially. So that's
wow, excellent.
Improvement.
Great stuff.
And it's just nice, you know, I feel I'm able to go out if I choose to go out.
Yeah.
Because I know that he's looked after and he's comfortable and he's in safe hands, if you know what I mean.
Yes, yeah. And it gives you that peace of mind and a bit of respite yourself.
Yes, so it's good.
Yeah. So have you got involved in the golfing or have you just been chilling out?
I've just been shopping.
Have you? Okay. So, yeah. So you get a chance to...
a good pastime to have.
Excellent. Yes. Yes. Yeah.
So it's good. And everybody's so friendly. The environment is nice. The golf club is really accommodating.
It's a beautiful place as well.
We have cups of tea. They do exercise before they go golfing.
Yep.
The participants do exercise, which is really good. Loosens them up and strengthens them. So,
yes.
I've just got nothing but praise for the whole setup.
So you'd highly recommend it then?
I would highly recommend it, yes.
Brilliant. It's great to see all the smiles here today. Well, it's lovely.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
It's a nice environment and everybody is so lovely.
Yes, yeah, I can tell.
It's
yeah.
Good. It's good.
Brilliant. Thank you very much. Hi Arthur, pleased to meet you by the way, you're a very funny man, he was making everybody giggle early, weren't you?
I don't hear very well.
Oh sorry, okay.
No, you're alright.
Okay,
right.
I'll try and properly enunciate. So how are you enjoying the sessions?
Yeah, it's alright.
Yeah.
Some lovely stuff.
Yeah.
They told me to say that.
Did they? Have they paid you for that?
Yeah.
Excellent. So what do you find best about it? What's the best part?
It's mixing.
Yes.
You know, getting out and mixing and enjoying myself.
Yeah.
I wish I'd never given away my golf clubs.
Oh, did you have some before? So you're a previous player then?
Only for myself. I didn't competitively have one.
No. You know, no, I tried.
If
it's hard work.
If I wanted to move the ball, I moved it. You know.
So how is your golf? Has it improved since you've been doing this?
The listening, I bet. No, I think it's much the same.
Yeah.
But it gets you out in the fresh air.
Absolutely. Do you compete as well then? Do you compete against each other? Or?
Yes.
It's bragging rights.
You know, 5 points for getting in the umbrella.
Is it? Excellent. Yeah. Five. That's good.
You do think of different things to do.
Yeah.
And indoor, there's a mat putting green there.
Oh, okay. Is that the best part of your game, or is it driving?
Oh, I don't know.
You don't know? You're not sure?
I cheat a lot.
It is the best bet
you've seen. It sounds like you're good at that. Excellent. Yeah. Oh, good. It's lovely to talk to you. So how long have you been doing the you've been here? You just said you've done the halfway, 10 weeks, so you've done 6 weeks, yeah. So you've got another 6 weeks to go, excellent, before the bad weather starts.
It's a long way from home,
is it? So where are you from then? Where?
Wingerworth.
So you come a fair way then?
It's quite a trek.
Yeah. But it's obviously well worthwhile.
My taxi driver.
Is it? Excellent stuff. Well, lovely to meet you. And thank you very much. Sorry?
Same with you, lad.
Yeah, thank you. Lovely to meet you. And good luck with the rest of it.
Following the lovely discussion with Sue and Arthur, I then moved on to Murray and his carer Jane.
Well, lovely to meet you, Murray. You've just been out there, have you? Just been out there. So who? So you? We've just been talking to Arthur, obviously. Who's the better golfer?
I am.
You are.
I'm the best golfer of the lot.
Is that because you're Scottish then? Is that?
Yes.
Is it because you're from?
Yes.
So are you? Did you used to play golf? Or is it a continuation of what you used to play?
As a youngster.
Have you? Okay. So. So you're a proper player then?
Well, I played since I was a youngster, that's all I can say. I didn't play too much. I worked in London when I first started.
Okay.
I didn't play at all there.
Right, yeah, it's difficult around there. Right.
With work.
Yes.
And I started playing straight away.
Yeah.
And I've just stayed.
Excellent.
Yeah, so I'm retired, just stayed in Sheffield because I like it.
So what did you work as in Sheffield then?
I was working in the banking business.
Oh, okay.
But in the computing side.
Yes, all right, so you were cutting edge.
Yeah.
Excellent. So what do you find best about the sessions then? What's the favourite part of it?
Getting back into playing.
Yes.
You know, just to have some sort of club in my hand and hitting the ball and stuff like that.
Yeah, yeah. So which part do you prefer? Do you like the driving or the actual golf?
The whole lot. Yeah.
Brilliant stuff.
I like to play the whole thing.
So how do you get on with everybody?
They're
a very lovely bunch of people.
Yeah, I get fine with all the boys.
Yeah, it's really, really positive.
But don't tell Jane.
Good man. So how long have you been doing it? Have you, same as Arthur, you've been doing it about 6-7 weeks? Or?
I've been doing it over a year.
Oh, right, okay.
My memory's
you're the long-termer. Right. Yeah, good stuff. So nice. It's an amazingly positive thing. It's lovely to see.
It is. I really enjoy it.
So you see yourself doing this for a long time?
Oh yeah, until something happens. I'm still playing.
Yeah.
But I'm not very good. So I keep doing this until I improve.
Yes. Oh, great stuff. And your game is improving.
I don't know. I can't remember.
Oh right. Okay.
Therefore, no.
But there's loads of support, isn't there? And is it Tom who's a professional? He's really good at getting people's games up to speed, isn't he?
Yeah. Good.
I think I'm a lost cause myself, but I think I'm sure you're obviously very good at it.
Well, I'm reasonable.
Right. Wow. Well, lovely. Great stuff. Well, I'm really, really pleased that you're enjoying it.
I am.
It's
good.
Yeah. Great stuff. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Murray.
Cheers.
Cheers. Right then, Jade. So you come today as support.
Yes, I bring Murray, and then I often just pop to the shops. And
so you are another one who gets to the shops.
Yes.
So it gives you some peace and quiet, does it?
Yes.
Excellent.
Yeah. Murray doesn't like shopping, so it gives me a chance to go around the supermarket.
Fabulous. Oh, great stuff. So altogether, have you found it really, really valuable to you as well?
Yes. Yeah, it's really nice to, you know, have that bit of time to myself.
Yeah.
I know that Murray's fine here, he's happy.
And looked after.
Enjoying it.
Brilliant stuff. Yeah. No, it's lovely. Lovely to see. It's, as I said earlier with Murray, it's lovely and positive. So you just wanted to continue doing it and...
Yeah, whilst ever Murray's happy doing it.
And you get to chauffeur, do you?
Yes.
Yes, dear. Oh, lovely.
And that's fine.
But it's obviously doing well. He's got a massive smile on his face, so, aren't you?
I love it.
Every week when he's finished, he always says how much his angels are.
Fabulous.
And the people. Yes. Fantastic.
Yeah.
And it seems that anybody new that starts, they're lovely as well.
Yes.
So, you know, it's a really positive group.
Well, we're trying to recruit some more people to join you, so hopefully it works. So.
And I think this golf club are very welcoming to...
They are. It's a beautiful place, isn't it? Yeah. Really nice place to be.
Every year.
Yeah.
I used to play every year.
Yeah, yeah. I didn't know it was here.
Yeah.
As soon as you said Hillsborough, I thought, well, I can't remember one being around Hillsborough, but it's Worrell, yeah.
Yeah.
But it's a lovely place. Really, really good. So thank you very much.
It was really wonderful to meet everyone at Hillsborough Golf Club and see the fabulous work that Golf in Society do. To finish the show, I thought I'd speak to volunteer Jill Lomax, who can tell you how to get involved.
So welcome, Jill. Thank you very much for agreeing to be interviewed. We just want to know more about what you actually do. Initially, I just want to ask you what your role is and how you got involved in this charity.
Hi. I was asked by a friend who is actually the manager of Golf and Society. I used to work with her. She's the manager for Sports Confidence, but she works alongside Golf and Society. And she asked me, she was talking to me about it. And I said, oh, that sounds a fantastic opportunity. I'd like to get involved. So initially I started as a volunteer. And then from that, I'm now a recruitment lead for Golf and Society. So I do a bit of both. I do some volunteer work on a Tuesday at Hillsborough Golf Club, and then the rest of the time I'm trying to recruit participants for Golf in Society.
We'll learn more about that later on in the interview. So what do you really like about the work that you do with Golf in Society?
It's just so refreshing to work in a beautiful environment where people come along, they have a chance to natter, have a cuppa, talk freely about any problems. It's all free. There's physiotherapy there, there's occupational therapy, and we even help people to get there via transport. It's fun. And when sometimes you say golf, you know, people think eyes glaze over and they think, oh no, I can't do that. But this is accessible golf for everyone. It's fun. It's more like a bit of putting, a bit of chipping, and on the driving range. And even if you can't walk very far, it's just a short, you know, distance doing that. So it's not walking around a big, huge golf course.
Yeah, Maurice, one of the participants, he was saying one of the things they do is they chip into an umbrella. And it's whoever can get the most balls in it and everything. And he was saying how competitive it is as well, which is brilliant. I mean, I really, really enjoyed talking to him and Tony.
That's right. I mean, on days where it's not very nice weather, we can do it indoors as well. So we have a facility indoors where we can put tape on the floor and they can play golf on the carpet. So that's nice as well. So it's indoors and outdoors.
Brilliant. So what do the golfers get out of it and what do the carers get out of it?
I think the carers get a chance to come and speak to other carers and talk about any issues they're having and share them. And they're building up friendships, and you can see that in relationships. They're looking forward to coming, you know, every week where they can spend time with other people, talk about their issues. Some actually go off and do their own thing. So they've been looking after the loved one all week, and they use that 2 hours to go and, you know, have a read somewhere in a library or go and have a coffee somewhere. So, and also the carers can take part as well. So they can have an opportunity to play golf as well. So I think there's three things that the carers get out of it.
Yeah, I mean, the favourite when I did the interviews with them was actually going shopping. And saying what a luxury it was just to be able to get a couple of hours where they can get everything done and not have to care for someone.
That's right. So they can have that time to themselves, whereas some like to come and stay and take part, and others, you know, go off and have that me time really for themselves. It's a godsend. They look forward to it. It's the highlight of the week. Coming to golf and society.
So how can our listeners get involved in the sessions at Tinsley?
What they do is, I've been giving out leaflets, but what they do is there's a phone number, so they just have to ring this phone number with my name on, Jill Lomax or Liz Fletcher. So there's both phone numbers on it, and they can email us. And I don't know if you've got information to our emails and phone numbers, but I can certainly...
We've got them on the banner. If anybody wants to have a look, they're on their social media banners. So they're on Facebook, they're on Twitter. We've also put them on Instagram. So they're there actually on the banners. But we will put more and more out. We will put it in the text of the banners and everything as well.
Yeah. So they just ring up, they give their details, you know, their issue, if they've got any, you know, problems with walking and that type of thing. So we can get that kind of information. And where they live, etc., so we can organise transport if need be, and then that's it, as simple as that. And then we can organise for them coming, have a taster session, see if they like it, and then take it from there. Yeah.
No, it's absolutely superb. I had a look at the website as well. There are plans to get into more sports, aren't there as well? Is that true?
There's talk about, you know, people have mentioned darts, football, snooker. So I think whatever hobby that people like, we try and do more of it, get people together in a social hub, try and improve their psychological well-being and improve their social skills, really. And it's a lot of people do feel isolated as they get older. And I think they look forward to coming here to be part of something, and like a sense of belonging, really, and improves their mental health, hopefully.
It felt like a social club when I went there. People obviously really, really value the time there. And they obviously really enjoyed it. It was fabulous to see.
Yes.
Good stuff. Thank you very much, Jill. Hopefully we can get some new recruits for you.
Hopefully, yeah, lots of them. Thank you
very much. Thank you. Bye.
As mentioned in the programme, you can contact Jill Lomax direct on 07598 265 4228. Or you can email her direct in golfinsociety.study@gmail.com.
Four. Straight down the middle. It went straight down the middle. Then it started to hook just a wee bit. And that's when my caddy lost sight of it. That little white pellet has never been found to this day. But it went straight down the middle, like they say. Whack down the fairway. It went smack down the fairway. Then it started to slice just a smidge off line. It headed for two, but it bounced off nine. My caddy says, long as you're still in the state, you're okay. Yes, it went straight down the middle, quite a way. The sun was never brighter, the greens were never greener, and I was never keener to play. I heard it ping down the middle, it went zing down the middle. Oh, the life of a golfer is not all gloom. There's always the lies in the locker room. And I'm in my glory when wrapped in a towel I say that it went straight down the middle today.